St. Mark chapter 9, verse 38.
Come on.
And Paul answered him, saying, Master, we saw one casting out devils by Hashem Mashiach Yahushua, and he followed not us.
Right, he said, look, we see one casting out demons in your name, Yahushua, and he not with us, he not ruling directly with us. Go ahead.
And we forbade him, because he followed not us.
Right, he forbid that cat. Get out of here. You're not working with Yahushua. You're not part of the true gospel and ministry. Get out. What y'all doing casting out demons in his name? Right. That cat ain't rolling with us. Go ahead.
But Mashiach Yahushua said, forbid him not, for there is no man which shall do a miracle by Hashem Mashiach Yahushua.
Right, so Yahushua said, there's no man that can do a miracle in my name sincerely. Sincerely, right? Come on.
That can lightly speak evil of me.
Right, Yahushua said, look, if a cat is doing miracles in my name, he can't speak lightly of me. Go ahead.
For he that is not against us,
come on,
is on our part.
What'd he say?
For he that is not against us.
Right, Yahushua said, he that is not against us, come on,
is on our part.
Right, so if a brother is by Hashem Mashiach Yahushua, he's for Yahushua. Because he's not with particularly your camp or your school. Because a lot of y'all run with that too. A lot of y'all run with Yahushua is only dealing with us. The Most High in Christ only dealing with us. But Yahushua said, if he not against me, he's for our part. Right? Come on.
For whosoever shall give you a cup of water.
Oh, that's it on that. Right? I just want that part. Whosoever is not against us is for our part. Link that up with Matthew 12 and 30. Go to Matthew chapter 12, verse 30. This is basic stuff, man. But we got to go over it because this is what happened amongst our people in the ancient times. So, you know, we have to reiterate and put these things in remembrance, like it tells us in Jude. Right? Go ahead. Same Matthew 12 and 30 to link up with Mark 9, 38 to 40. Read that, brother.
St. Matthew chapter 12, verse was it
30, yeah.
Verse 30.
Come on.
He that is not with me is against me.
Come on.
And he that gathered not with me scattered abroad.
Right, so Yahushua said, he that is not with me is against me, and he that gathereth not with me scattereth abroad. Meaning, it didn't have to physically be with Yahushua like we read in Mark, but if he's gathering in Yahushua's name, then he's gathering with Yahushua. We're not telling the people, if you're from a different camp, you're not telling them to go and be a Muslim or be a Christian that don't follow Yahushua. You tell them to repent through Yahushua as a Hebrew Israelite. That's bringing us all under Yahushua in the same mind. It tells us that in Thessalonians, we're going to be our gathering is to Yahushua. Right? So that's who we're being gathered to. As far as us all being under the same congregation physically, that's up to the Most High and Yahushua to do. You know, a lot of Israel say that ain't going to happen to the kingdom. I mean, you know, I agree with that to a certain degree, but whatever the Most High going to do, he going to do in his last days. He can gather us all together, or, you know, he can gather us together in the kingdom. However, he's going to do it according to scripture. But Israel, in these last days, we are going to gather to a certain degree, because when the affliction come down, they're going to label all of us the same.
That's right.
Right? We're going to be one common enemy to Esau.
Gone.
So, you know, as we're moving forward, you know, the Most High is going to put us where he wants us to be anyway, regardless, by Hashem Mashiach Yahushua. Right, so go to, now let's flip to, go to 2 Timothy 1. 2 Timothy 1 and start at 13, I believe it is. Yeah, get some more examples, you know. 2 Timothy 1 and 13, yeah, that's what I want.
2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 13.
Yeah, that's what I want, good.
Hold fast the form of sound words, which thou hast heard of me, and faith and love, which is in Hamashiach Yahushua.
From one.
That good thing which was committed unto thee, keep by the Holy Spirit which dwelleth in us.
Go ahead.
This thou knowest, that all they which are in Asia be turned away from me, of whom are
Figulus, go ahead,
and
Hermogenus. Right, so now what happened is these two brothers, Figulus and Hermogenus, they were two brothers that was against Paul and against Paul's teachings also. And what they had did was they had turned all the congregation that was in Asia against Paul. Right, so you had the same thing going on back then. Let me read about it in the history. All right, this is the Zondervan Compact Bible Dictionary under page 458 under Figulus. It says, Paul mentions by name Figulus and Hermogenes as being among those Christians of Asia, Western province of Asia Minor, who had turned away from the apostle. From the content, 2 Timothy 1:13, 14, 15, it may be assumed that the apostasy included the repudiation of Paul's doctrine. So in other words, the falling away from Paul, the apostasy, the falling away from Paul, included the repudiation of Paul's doctrine. In other words, the rejection of Paul's doctrine. Right? So, once again, what do you have in these last days? Man, I don't like what that man is teaching. That man is off. Right? That one West doctrine. And they turned all the congregation that was in that region of Asia Minor against Paul at the time. It says, some scholars feel that Figulus may also have been one of the leaders of a group of wayward Christians in Rome. In other words, you know, a rebellious cast that just want to do their own thing. Just to hell with Paul, we don't want to be under him. You know what I'm saying? So you got the same thing going on back then. Same thing. That's why you get a lot of this contention and fighting now. You got wayward camps now. Camps that just want to leave. We ain't under none of these men. Right, all they teach it, they all in that one West doctrine. We gonna do our own thing.
Right.
Right, them niggas is wicked. Right. Right? You got that going on. You know what I'm saying? Which the whole one West doctrine, I'm gonna do a separate video on that. Maybe when we come back next week. All but right. That's getting out of hand too. Go to Ephesians 4. Go to Ephesians 4:1. Under that one West doctrine. Look, the truth is the truth, man.
That's right.
Whether you like it, understand it, accept it, believe it or not, any of these scriptures I'm bringing out today, where can you say that's a one West doctrine? I'm explaining them as they're written. Huh. So where can you say it's a one West doctrine? It's the scriptures. It's no one West doctrine. It's the Bible. But I'm going to do a separate video on that anyway. But go to Ephesians 4 and start at 13.
Ephesians chapter 4, verse 13.
Come on.
Till we all come in the unity of the faith.
And see, that's why you have a lot of this division, camp fighting and all that also, because we got to come in the unity of the faith. Come on.
And of the knowledge of the Son of the Most High unto a perfect man.
Come on.
Unto the measure of the stature of the fullness of Mashiach.
Come on.
That we henceforth be no more children tossed to and fro.
Come on.
And carried away with every wind of doctrine.
Right, carried about with every wind of doctrine. Right. Go ahead.
By the sleight of men.
Right, by the trickery or the wickedness of men. Go ahead.
And cunning craftiness.
And what?
Cunning craftiness.
And cunning craftiness. Come on.
Whereby they lie and wait to deceive.
So my main point is we ought to come in the unity of the faith of Yahweh Shai. And not toss to and fro with every wind of doctrine. So if the truth was the truth one time, how is it going to come along 40 years later and it's a different truth? It's the truth. Now, we might increase in wisdom. We might increase in understanding. Increase in, I tell you that in Daniel 12. But for the most part, the foundation of this truth that was taught back then, I stand behind it wholeheartedly. Because them same scriptures you read today has the same breakdown and meaning. You may have more in-depth wisdom on certain things. Like I said, brothers going to the Greek, the Hebrew. You got the concordance, the Strong's. You got the Blue Letter. You got all these other sources that brothers go deeper into. You got regular Greek and Latin. You go into the root, the Latin and Greek words. You know, you get a deep understanding. Yes, that's true. I'm not taking away from that. Meticulous study is good. But the foundation of what these scriptures is saying is the same thing. But, you're running with that one West doctrine. So the same thing they was doing back in the ancient time, they did it with Paul. So go back to where we was at, 2 Timothy 1. And I think we left off at 15. That one West doctrine. You're under that old one West teaching. The Bible is the Bible, man. It's the teachings of the Bible. Right? Now, we get deeper understanding of certain things. You know, iron sharpeneth iron, and we go through it, and we get a better understanding, and so be it. But the foundation of what was taught is still there. That doesn't change. right? So go to 16. 2 Timothy 1:16 now.
2 Timothy 1:16.
Come on.
Our power give mercy unto the house of Onesiphorus.
Yeah, Onesiphorus.
Onesiphorus.
Go ahead.
For he ought refreshed me.
Come on.
And was not ashamed of my chain.
Right, so Paul is just giving credit, you know, to brothers that had his back or stuck by him. Go ahead.
But when he was in Rome, he sought me out very diligently and found me.
Come on.
Our power grant unto him that he may find mercy of the Most High in that day, and in how many things he ministered unto me at
Ephesus,
thou knowest very well.
Right, so Paul was just showing the contrast of brothers that was against him, brothers that hated him, brothers that hated his doctrine, and didn't want to follow Paul's teachings, and turned the entire congregation of Asia, that region of Asia Minor, against him, as opposed to that brothers that was cool with him and had his back. So you had that same thing going on back then. Same thing. You got brothers that hate you, would make 30 videos against you and turn a whole heap of Israelites against you. Then you got brothers that'll be there for you on your most trying times. They got your back because they love you as a brother. Even in your weaknesses, your shortcomings, and their sins, they still love you and pray for you and wish the best for you as a sincere brother.